Welcome to Conquests of Longbow. I'm your host, lostwolfe. It is day 6, or day 5, dependent on how you look at it. Yesterday, or the day before at least, we came back to the cave and we had this over here. Now, what this is it's a bundle of clothing. That is the black robe of the fence monk. And as you accrue more pieces of clothing, they will end up over here, setting you up for different disguises. The other thing that we did yesterday, or the day before at least, was we got these scrolls, which we've looked at, but we also got this ring that we haven't looked at. Lapis Lazuli sent a ring of silver. So, that is the ring of ice, of course. And let's go see what today has in store for us. You're looking thoughtful. Wool says he's just gotten word that Hal, Hob, and Dickon will hang at sunset today. Hob and me grew up together. He's like one of my own brothers. Much, I swear, I'll do all I can to save them. So this gives you your job for today. We have to go and rescue the three brothers. I think the poor widow will die if she loses all of her sons. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to do is, as ever, we're going to go to the overlook on Watling Street. Now, before we get into this game is cool in one sense. It tracks what you do. In the episode 4 day 5, or day 6, depending on how you look at it, we shot and killed the black-robed monk. But if you recall, they were walking at opposite ends. They were walking down the one side, and the brown-robed monk was walking up the other side. So, they were together on the same screen. Sierra literally did the scene again, but this time, you'll see and notice. Just as soon as this happens. That there is only one monk. If you recall, the one monk was not the Fens monk. Just a monk from the Abbey of St. Mary's in Nottingham. We need to go down there. We need to get there before he goes away. I hope I got it right. I don't want to have missed him because then we have to do that again. Top of the day to you, brother. Thank you. Did you want something? What brings you along the Watling Street? I'm not really supposed to discuss it with strangers, but no one would miss you for quite some time if you didn't return. Oh mercy, don't hurt me. Why, I've done nothing but talk to you. There's no need to panic yet. Okay, so as with everything related to this game, there are a number of situations and ways that you can approach this. This guy is very worried about being hurt, so the simplest thing to do is just to be threatening. But of course, as with Robin Hood, there are lots of ways you can be threatening. I mean, you could shoot the guy. Let's talk to him for a little bit. You wouldn't harm a man of the cloth, would you, sir? And how is it a man of the cloth requires so much cloth to cover his enormous belly? Oh, before we go any further, I want you to notice the portrait of the monk. That's going to be important. What are those who go hungry while you eat well? And those who are forced to toll upon the abbot's grandiose abbey and the threat of excommunication. You'd really have to take that up with his grace. Feh, what a useless bloody conversation this is. You're right. May I go now? I'll think about it. Don't harm me, I beg you. I'm only a poor helpless monk. I go weary of this tired refrain. Have mercy, he's going to say it a lot. Anyway, so let's walk over to him. Please don't hurt me, I beg you. Don't be a fool. I'm not even close to you. You can still talk to him if you want. Don't harm me, I beg you. I'm only a poor helpless monk. And we can try and grab his robes, of course. Don't hurt me, I beg you. Don't hurt me. Don't be a fool, I scarcely touched you. You have the spine of an earthworm. I have nothing to please an outlaw, neither gold nor silver. Have mercy. Come now, there is no need for such fear. That there isn't? I may go my way? I keep on trying to put my own way in there. But, is that a problem? Oh nay, whatever you want, the robe is yours, if you'll just spare me. That's better. A visit to my camp will refresh you. You can learn the value of good, honest labor. Have mercy. Sorry, I skipped past the dialogue there. He wanted the robe. Robin wanted the robe. This is the only scene that I don't like here. And that, have mercy. Oh, good fire. How can you consort with these thieves and rogues? Take me to town and the abbot will reward you well. Keep chopping or I'll reward you with the flat of my blade again. I don't think there's any need for this. He's already scared as it is. All they have to do is ask him politely to chop wood. Robin, why you make a fine figure of a monk in that robe? Bless you, my son. Take good care of our guest. I am off to Watling Street. And then they kind of linger on this for too long. It's just not pleasant. When he's finished with this, I'll take him up to gather more firewood to chop. He'll know the true meaning of honest work when I'm done with him. Have mercy. The scene could have been done a long time ago. Anyway, so we're at Watling Street. Now, what we know from everything that we've been told is that the widow's boys, are being kept in Nottingham. So let's head there. And of course, there's lots of little places that you can go in the town of Nottingham. But we want to go to the castle. There's a man over here. Good sir, please allow me to administer to those poor souls in your dungeon. They're only outlaws. Are they not lost sheep? Surely you would not send them to their deaths unshriven. And this is why I wanted to make a point of pointing out what unshriven is, because it's going to come up a lot. It's not for me to say. I have orders. No one is to be admitted. And you can keep talking to him if you like. I ask you again to let me shrive those unfortunate souls in your dungeon before they are hung. Sorry, I have my orders. Of course, I've been persuaded to bend the rules a bit from time to time. And of course, this persuasion is giving him money. So, let's do that. I need to save because I think I'm going to get it wrong. That's fine. Actually, you know what we should do? We need to delete some of these. Only because I have some stuff that I need to do. So we're going to do episode 6 here. Okay, so let's give the man some money. We're running a bit low on money, so we're going to have to replenish our stock at some point. Let's give him this. Sorry, I was checking my notes for how much I need to give him. My son, I cannot bear the thought that any man, even these villainous outlaws that the sheriff plans to hang, should go to his death unshriven. Will this move you to compassion, so that I may go to the dungeon and administer unto them? I'm deeply moved, brother. Your plea has touched me. Portrait Giles. Escort this monk to the dungeon and let him speak to the prisoners, but make it quick. This monk is here to give the outlaws their final blessing. You have to do it through the trapdoor. At least allow me to hear their sins alone. You can wait for me upstairs. Sorry, can't leave you alone in here. Get on with it. My sons, I've come to pray for your wicked souls. Lift up thine eyes and attend unto me. A pox on you, monk. But that's... Oh, Dickon, don't do that. A hooded man. Aye, we see you now, brother. And with glad eyes, what would you say to us? That salvation may yet be yours if you will follow my path. Wherever you lead us, brother, we will follow, if God wills. Aye, if God wills, for it is my duty to lead you from the darkness into the light, and I shall not fail in my duty, even should the devil himself block my path. That's enough. Shrive their souls and be done with it. Have faith, my sons. Domine Dei J. Nos. Come with me before the sheriff comes along and has our hides for letting you in at all. Okay, so that done. Let's head out of here. So, okay. Let's talk about the setup for this. The way it's all set up is that most of the action that we're going to have to deal with is going to involve getting Hal, Dickon, and Hob out of the castle. But there's a whole host of little steps along the way. And the thing about this game, unlike with most serial games, is that there are possibilities for failure along the way that don't end the game. They just make the ending worse. I'm not going to show you all the steps along the way that make the ending worse, but you do need to be aware that you can screw up, but it's never the end of the game, truly, until the final day when you're done. This is probably day 5 and 6 are the, probably the most heavy going days for this particular game, because there's so much happening in them. So, first thing we want to do is head to the Abbey. This is St. Mary's. Now, one of the things that you'll notice about the Abbey at this point is that it is being built. It's not quite done yet. That's not vitally important, but it is interesting historically. Good day, brother. And remember what I said? Same portrait. Remember to bar the door once you've inside. Of course, brother. Okay, so this is basically a church. These are all pews over here. Pews. This is where the church will be. Actually, these are not pews. These are rooms. If you go and click on them, you'll see that each of them are rooms. These monks don't lead such a hard life with quarters like these, but they're nothing I want. Oh, but they've nothing I want. So these are all rooms. Sorry, my bad. This is an abbey. It's going to be like the monastery. But here's a funny thing. Larry? Patty? What are you doing here? No, this isn't at the Nottingham Swinging Singles Health Spa. This is a little bit before Larry 5, where things changed in Or it might be a little after. It might be before Larry 6, before that all changed. Anyway, there's lots of little Easter eggs. I haven't been showing them to you, but as with Conquests of Camelot, there's lots of little Easter eggs that you can find in the game. Anyway, so there are different rooms here. There. Here's a room as well. This is a very well-appointed room. This isn't strictly where we're supposed to go quite yet, but I do want to show you sort of around before we do anything. The door is locked. We can tell from this particular little drawing of the room, though, that it's nicely appointed. There is also a spot over here. In front of me lies the chapel. Behind me, the unfinished nave. Oh, do I have to walk there? I guess I do. This magnificent gilded and bejeweled reliquary holds a sliver, of the true cross which legend says was brought back from Jerusalem by King Arthur. And this is tying back to the previous game, which I like a lot. The windows are most beautiful. The color of light uplifts my soul. There's a brother walking around. They all look fat and ugly to me. It's not very nice. The scriptures are laid open upon the altar. Now there are two doors here, one on the left and the one on the right. We can go through both of them. I am gonna save. Because here's the tomfoolery in this episode. This game includes a maze. Now right now, as of this minute, we don't necessarily need to be in a maze. It's not something that we have to do. But we're going to walk it very quickly just so we can get the lay of the land for the maze. Oh, game designers. Why do you include mazes in your games? I believe I'm doing this correctly. Go, go. Here. No, Robin. Don't be silly. At least this maze isn't nearly as bad as the one in, Inherit the Earth. Because this one you can sort of make sense of just by looking at it. Inherit the Earth's maze was not like that at all. Inherit the Earth's couple of mazes weren't like that at all. Oh dear. Game, I didn't want to go that way. I wanted to, in fact, go this way. No. I guess I'm just going to have to walk this with the cursors. Because Robin is being silly. That is the one good thing about these games, though, is that because they were built before the time of mouse-driven everything, you could use your cursor keys to do some of the work. And yeah, we have what we're actually after. This is what you need to know about. The maze has brought me out into the witch's court. It's entirely enclosed by the stone wall with two large wooden gates set in the northern wall. They're closed now, but when open, they would allow a large crowd of spectators to enter. Okay, so the witch's court is exactly what it sounds like. There's a door here and a door here, and those will let people in. There is a... The abbot has built a spectator stand versus Blackheart. It's difficult to tell that this is a stand. It looks like the sun is coming in here and shining on that. And I don't know what you'd call that. But this is the stand here, and here is the actual stake. The abbot had this thing built. A stake within a small pyre. Twice he has burned old women he accused of being witches. A vile foreign notion that causes great unease among the townsfolk. I wager he keeps this court locked so the people do not sneak in here and destroy this thing. That is true. Anyway, we need to be aware of this and how to get here and which door leads out. Because we're going to have to do this again. Take that robe off here? And me with naught a stitch of clothing underneath? I think not. No, Robin. It's heading for the door. So, one of the things that you may have noticed about the maze is that there were two doors when we came in. So there is another way that you can get out of the maze, which is over here. go down. Thank you. where am I? I think I am over. I want to be over here. And then I believe I want to be down this way. Well, we'll know soon because we're going to watch this side here. Yeah, I believe I picked the right way. And if I keep going left, I'll end up there and up. So we need to know how to be able to walk this maze because we'll eventually end up in it. And under time pressure and all that nonsense. So here we come out this side. Anyway, that is the worst part of this episode, really. Knowing how to walk the maze. There are other little rooms here. I'm not going to go into this one yet, but this is a room you need to be aware of. I see the refectory. Yes, refectory. And the abbot is within, on the far end of the room. I see a laundry room within. Oh, sorry. I thought these two rooms were separate. Anyway, so let's go into the laundry room. This is pretty convenient. There are three robes just hanging out there. The three freshly washed robes and sash belts have been hung to dry. Let's grab them. Good. They're mostly dry. Nothing worse to carry around than wet wool. Now that the... Okay, so that was the setup part of today's episode done. From here on, it's basically all action. So we're going to do a whole string of things. These abbey monks have the softest of wool for their robes and strong silk sashes for belts. Out we go. Because we got everything we need in this room. The one great thing about this game is that it doesn't burden you with a lot of inventory. It's very easy to tell what you need to do next. I see. Okay. Go inside. Thank you. A large, richly woven tapestry covers nearly the entire back wall. There is another... Easter egg here, which I'm not going to show off. But if you put a clock, well, we may as well just do it since we're here. Oh, okay. I thought I knew how to trigger it, but I don't, so it's fine. We won't worry about it. I'll come back around and I'll do all the Easter eggs because there's lots of them. Don't worry, we'll have one episode that just does that. Could I be of service to you, Your Grace? Aye, that you can, brother. This bloody puzzle box is driving me mad, and I'm down to my last mug of ale. Trot over to the pub and get me more of his most potent brew. Forgive my ignorance, but why don't you simply break open the box? Because it's too well made, that's why. And besides, it's supposed to contain a magic ring, a perfect ruby set in flames, made of gold, and I'll not take my chances on damaging it. Not that it's any of your business. Be on your way. Shall I take the empty cask with me, Your Grace? Fie, who cares? What that innkeeper charges me, he can afford to lose a few casks. But make sure you bring back his best ale, none of that poisonous, scrumpy cider stuff. Pardon me, but how shall I pay for it? I notice you have your purse. Enough addle-pated questions. He'll bull me as he always does. Now I'll be off with you. It's not immediately obvious, but there's a cask and a glass over here. So, let's try and steal the glass. Get back here quickly with that ale, and I might consider giving you a drop. And let's grab the cask. Okay. He looks thirsty and impatient. Clearly to Sapphire Place. And try very hard with some of the descriptions. Anyway. Let's head out of here. So he said to go and get him some ale. That is precisely what we're going to do. Now, prior to us, I'm no use to go that part of town. Prior to us coming into town before, we've never been able to go to places like the pub, because what would a beggar be doing in the pub? But now we can go in without trouble. Okay. So, let's look around. Behind door bars the way into a beer cellar. Now, hang on. Notice this line here with the bucket? That's very important. It's a bucket, lowered on a rope through a hole in the sandstone roof. Innkeeper, what's the meaning of the lowered bucket? The soldiers lower it from the castle walls with money in it, and I fill it with ale, which they haul back up. This is important to know, because we need to be aware that this is how the soldiers get drink. Let's talk to the innkeeper. Innkeeper, barkeep. You don't look familiar. You must be new to the order. Either I am. Would your hospitality to a newcomer extend to a sample of your brew? It might, if your miserly abbot bothered to pay his bill. What's more, he never sends back casks, so I have no temper to be generous. Go ask him for a free ale. And we have this guy in a corner over here. An immense marsh game is carved into the top of this table. This poor old fellow looks as though he's led a hard life and seeks to forget it with a jug or two of nut brew brown ale. Okay, let's talk to the man. You've the look of a man who's been to foreign lands.
I've been to the Holy Land, saw Jerusalem, I did. Killed heathens and watched many a Christian die, and the ground run red with blood. Served with King Richard until he made peace with Saladin, and sent us packing home.
I love the name Saladin. Saladin is a guy in King's Quest V. Saladin is awesome. But then days is gone. If you have a mind for a game of Landman's Morris, I'm willing to lighten your purse.
I'll consider it.
Okay. We are going to play Nine Men's Mars, but we are going to play it in a wimpy way. You can skip Nine Men's Mars, of course, but we need to play it because I need you to see how it works. This is my seat. Go sit over there if you have a mind to play Mars with me. Mind if I sit here? If you have a mind to play Mars, sit. If not, go elsewhere. I'll think upon it. How'd you go losing none of the playing pieces, Monk? You're a good Mars player? Well, Harry's one of the best. We'll see about that. Well, sit yourself down then, if you're not all talk. If you care for a wager, I'll wager something worth your while. This here chunk of amethyst. Got magic in it, it does. So if you have a mind to win it, bring out your money. Okay. I think I need to give him a penny. My notes don't say how much. I'm going to give him a penny. I don't think that's the right answer, but I'm going to do it. Here's my bet, then. Glad to meet a monk what knows how to open his purse. I'll be generous and let you go first, monk. Okay, so let's talk about Nine Men's Mars. Nine Men's Mars has got two phases. In the first phase, you place stones. Now, I believe that we're going to be the black pieces, and he's going to be the white pieces. You can place the stones anywhere where there's a connection. So, there's a connection, here's a connection, here's a connection.
The idea at first is to sort of build a kind of if you've ever played Noughts and Crosses, to build a kind of a situation where you can have Noughts and Crosses runs. But you don't have to do that. What you need to end up doing is making it so that you can move your stones into safe zones. And the minute you get three stones, like stone, 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 you get to take one of his pieces. I haven't played Nine Men's Morris in a very long time, so I'm going to be terrible at this. I may have to cut the recording here and just win, and you'll see the winning shot. But we'll try and play a game, and I'll probably lose. Take your turn, monk. Am I meant to wait till doomsday? Plop. So, if we place a piece here, we will be cutting him off there, but he will probably extend upward. So the idea is we are going to try and lead him. Now he doesn't want me to place three stones there, so what he's done is he's cut off my access to that, but that's fine. And again, we're just leading him along. On easy, he's probably not going to be terribly difficult to play against. Okay, so now he's leading me because he's put a stone here. If I put a stone there, I get to take one of his. There we go. And at last, we've won, monk. Here's your amethyst. We get the amethyst. What is the magic you claim it has? No claim, but the solemn truth. I swear it by the cross. Put this into your mug or goblet, and you can't get drunk, no matter how much ale or wine you drink. But surely you could have found a use for this yourself. Me? What do I be wanting with a spell that keeps me sober? Don't be a fool. Be warned, you can only use it once. And what then? It dissolves, is what? A heathen sorcerer put his spell on it, and that's all I know. Okay, so up we get. Okay, let's look at the amethyst that we won. This is a crystal amethyst. And let's give Barman the cask. I believe this empty cask belongs to you. Well, well, much appreciated, brother. You're the only one who's bothered to do me this service. Here's a new cask. Did the abbot send payment? Nay. Never mind. You were kind enough to bring the cask. But remind him that the bull is overdue. I shall, gladly. If you're in a hurry to get back, signal me from the cellar door, and I'll let you in so as you can go back the short way. What sort of signal? Like, you're trying to open it. That'll be enough. Okay, so this is the cellar. Since you brought me the cask, I'll let you go back the short way. But tell the abbot it's the last time if he doesn't pay up on his bull. This cask has carried many mugs of ale. I can't tell if it's full or empty. I hope it's full. Let's save. Because I'm not sure if it is. So anyway, these are all casks of ale, and the second one is the one you want. This cask doesn't feel nearly as heavy as the others, but still fixed solidly in place. I suppose the innkeeper's been drawing ale from it, and it's nearly empty. Ah, the tap unlatched. Something inside the cask. It's a false moat. It leads to a tunnel inside a sandstone. This tunnel from the cask leads up into the larger tunnel, which forks in two directions. This is the I'll go this way, you'll go home side. I hope someone at least recognizes that. Anyway, here we go. I climbed steeply upwards, probably somewhere up into the castle, atop this bluff. It seems to go on straight until it vanishes into the darkness. By my reckoning, it must run to the east beneath the streets of Nottingham Town itself. Let's go this way. Oh. I see tiny people in the center of the door. Just the grand night, isn't it, Giles? What's so bloody grand about it? We're stuck on duty in the dungeons, whilst the sheriff's throwing a party at the pub. Aye, but someone has to guard the prisoners. Bugger that. They're in a pit. Not a pair escaping. I don't see why we need to be here at all. Have they eaten? Aye, waste of food if you ask me. They'll be choking on ropes before long. I'll be looking on them, just the same. If you like. They look miserable, Giles. Of course they look miserable, you flap-eared Dorkin. They're going to die. There's no need to come over all insulting-like. We're to be on guard for half the night together. Aye, just my rotten luck. Anyway, so this is how you would know that they were in the actual cellar over there. We're going to rescue them. It's just going to take some doing. Let's head on this way. The sandstone tunnel runs fairly straight on for a long distance. What's this? It's another door. Heavy tapestry covers the doorway upon the other side. Dear male? Aye, your grace. Well, don't stand there like a dolt. Bring it over at once. Of course, your grace. You're slow, but at least you did the task. I have a mind to put the sail to the test. Have a seat and drink with me, brother. You can say nay, that's a bad idea. Then be seated, and we'll see how your stomach fares against mine. Brother Bruce, is that you? Another nameless brother. Aye, master. Good. Take this infernal box to my room, and leave my door unlocked. I'll be having a nap soon. Yes, you will. Oh, my lord. And now let's fill our mug. Okay. We need our amethyst. That is an exceptionally fine tapestry, Your Grace. But is that a floor I see in the center? There we go. What floor? I don't see a floor. Must be something wrong with your eyes. I believe you're right. Have another mug. Anyway, so now, since we're here and since we have the abbot all to ourselves, the important thing to do is to talk to him. I should wait until they stop drinking to talk to him. There. We should toast to long life for King Richard. Aye, long may he languish in a foreign prison. Have another mug. You're certain Prince John will succeed in preventing the king's ransom from being paid? Brother, he's as cunning as a boggart a rat, our prince is. The queen still needs over 50,000 marks, and the prince has made sure it eludes her grasp. Have another mug. 50,000 marks is no small sum. You must guard it well. Aye. And who do you think he trusts to guard it for him? Not the sheriff, but me. He sends it to me. When? Soon, I mean, soon. Have another mug. If I were the prince, I'd never dare to send such a treasure through Sherwood Forest. What of that arch outlaw, Robin Hood?
Fie on Robin Hood.
Treasure will be well guarded by the Baron Lefebvre and his men.
Still, you could send the Baron Lefebvre a warning about the outlaws.
Has he left for Nottingham yet?
Nay, not yet. You sure nosy, nosy monk.
Don't look much like a monk either.
Look more like an outlaw yourself.
Have another mug.
There is no answer.
Another mug, Your Grace.
Poof.
My trosh. Thank the Virgin for that amethyst. This truly is strong ale. I dare say the abbot will not wake for a good many hours.
Okay.
The innkeeper does brew truly fine ale. Let's grab the cask because we're going to need it. This empty cask may yet serve me again. And let's grab the abbot's purse. The contents of the abbot's purse would make a worthwhile addition to mine. By the time he notices his purse is empty, I should be far from here. We need the money, actually. It's more than that. Okay, let's head out. We got what we need. We have the information. And we have the stuff that he left behind. Ah, the door is unlocked and swings open easily. And inside I see what can only be the abbot's room. The abbot has spared himself no luxury, I see. There's one other door off to the left of this bed curtain. I see no other way to escape except the way I entered. I wonder where that monk would have put the puzzle box that the abbot was working on. This is rather easy to find. It's under the pillow. I found it. Now you need to make sure, let's just make sure we have the puzzle box, we do. You need to make sure that no one notices the theft, but not make my theft too obvious, because that could go badly. Let's get out of here. Okay, let's head down to the pub. Let's talk to the bartender. I suppose you've come back to pay the abbot's bill. If God wills it, it will be done. I guessed as much. How much is the bull? 12 pennies. I'll likely never see. Let's solve that problem for the innkeeper. Because remember, we got money. We got 16, so let's give him 12. Oops. What's all this? It's to pay the abbot's bill in full, my friend. I'm much obliged to you, brother. You're the only worthwhile monk I've ever met from the Abbey. No offense. None taken. So, the thing is, you want to have as many people on your side as possible for the end of the game. This is one way to do it, to help people, of course, when they're, like in this case, the abbot's just sitting in the Abbey, not actually ever paying his bill. This is one way to get that person on your side. Because in the end, of course, you will probably get unmasked as Robin Hood. And all these people will vouch for you. Now the thing we're going to do is give them the cask. Wait a moment, I'm busy. I brought back another empty cask. You are a good fellow. Do you want a full one to replace it? Nay, not this time. Okay, so let's head in here. Here you go, brother, and be careful. No one sees you using the secret way. I keep clicking an on spot. So we know that the sheriff is gonna host a, like a little party, and the party's probably winding up. You know, it's, the people are having their beer and whatnot. So let's see how that's doing. Will you stop that confounded pacing? I'm bored. Sneak us up a bucket of ale from the pub. That'll keep you busy. I've got such a thirst. I throttle me and mother for a mug right now. Give me some money then. Well, if you could pay for it this time. I knew it. You lost it all to old Harry playing nine men's marsh, didn't you? Oh, come on, Roger. Be a good lad. I haven't enough. We only need 4 pennies. I got 2 farthings, and that's it. Now remember, 2 farthings make a half a farthing. He won't fill the bucket for less than 4 pennies. So we need to put in 3.5. Sorry, that's all I've got. Hire yourself up the stairs and tell Jack I need a loan. What should I... Go on, by Jess. If I don't have an ale before the night is out, you'll never hear the end of it. Very well, if it'll improve your foul temper. Wait, I already owe Jack money. And we have to do this pretty quickly. So I'm gonna save. This is why we needed the Abbot's purse. We want to give them 3.5. And then we need to leave pronto. He wasn't much help, was he? Do you think he'll ever pay back the 2 farthings he just borrowed from me? He's a miserable little dung-eating ferret. I trow. I'd cut me on father's throat for a mug right now. I thank heaven that I'm not related to you, Giles. Roger, you sly old dog. What? You left this money on the table when I wasn't looking. What, I didn't know such thing. Have your little jest, if you like. Stay here while I fetch that ale. I'll never taste a drop if you fetch it. We'll both go. And again, we need to move. Lads, I'm back. Bless me, Robin. My heart nearly stopped when I realized it was you in that robe. And I almost cried out your name. Lower the ladder. There's none here. They must have it stored elsewhere, and I dare not leave this room. Then we're still trapped in this pit. Have faith. I'll find a way. Okay. So, remember those robes? They have the softest wool for their robes, and strong silk sashes for belts. Well, we can take the robe, have the robes and belts folded as small as possible. Take the robes and lower them in.
Long swords would be a great help once I get lads out of this pit, but belts. Get ready, lads. I'm going to make you a rope out of monk's belts. And up they come. Dickon, you next. You go next, Hob. You'll get up that rope right now or box your ears till they bleed. Quickly, while Hob climbs, take these robes into the tunnels and put them on. Okay, so let's talk to the men. Even in whispers, it's not a safe place to talk. Let's go this way. Okay. We should speak in whispers or not at all. Oh, it's blood. I'll be glad to see sunshine again. Well, I'll tell Mum about all this. Don't go that way. Your pardon, but we've no wish to go closer. I cannot blame you. The mouse pathfinding is giving me grief. There we go. There's no one in the cellar, though I hear some music. Hell going through, but if you sense anyone, I'll be careful, don't worry. What's all the noise, Hell? It's the sheriff with his men and some wenches. He's celebrating having three outlaws to hang. Do they look as though they've had plenty to drink? Aye, they're well into their cups. Good. That's twice the headache the sheriff will have when he finds you gone. But what should we do? Should we try to get past them as monks? Aye, on air, yes. Aye, we must dare it. The pub's outside the town walls and close to the forest. If they're drunk enough, the sheriff should pay little heed to some monks. Listen well, you three will go first. Keep your heads down, and don't hurry too much. Don't stop to wait for me no matter what happens. Hell, you lead the way. Brother, bless me. Heck. This is the sheriff. My son, you're drunk. Give me a blessing. Okay, let's do that. Very well. May God give you all that you deserve, and may I live to see it. Amen. What a great blessing. Best I ever heard. Here's a penny. Why, thank you, my son. Keep going and keep your eyes down. If we can reach the forest unnoticed, we'll be safe. I made a fine monk. You should have seen us. I thought I must laugh or die when the sheriff begged Robin for a blessing. Well, I didn't like being a monk, not for a minute. As soon as we reached the forest, I tore off that robe. You're all so brave. I can hardly believe you're here. It seems a miracle. May the Blessed Lady guard you and keep you safe forever, Robin Hood. But words aren't enough. Take this gift. The joy upon your face is payment enough. I will not be denied. This comes from the time when I was the guardian of the forest, even as Marian is now. Mother, you? A green priestess? Before you were born, I danced the spirit dance and nurtured the spirit of the forest. Step forward, Robin. This golden net is my gift. Use it well, and it will lead you to wisdom. Use it wisely, and the forest itself will protect you. Now please, Take my sons with you and let them serve you. I fear they are outlaws from the Stalin. I'll do as you bid. Thank you for all these precious gifts you bestow upon me. Come on, lads. Now notice that your outlaw count has gone up. Hellhob and Dickon bade their mother farewell and set about making a place for themselves in the camp. I joined my men for a joyous celebration. May you get all you deserve, and may I live to see it. Robin, you've a wicked wit. This will make one of the finest tales I've ever told. If the sheriff but knew what it is I think he deserved. I think he knows. He'll be cursing you roundly tonight, when the truth seeps into his drunken skull. Let him curse and rage. Hell, Hob and Dickon are beyond his reach, and I'm well content with this day's work. And I'm as proud as a man can be to call Robin Hood my leader. Let us toast him, men. A hood, a hood, a Robin Hood. I sort of think they should have kept that for the end of the game, but it's fine. Here we have a new set of clothing. We have some stuff in our inventory, but the important thing is we have 34 outlaws. You can lose outlaws, so that's bad, but we've gained some, so that's good. Anyway, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, Lostwolfe. This has been my friend Conquest's Longbow. I hope that you're enjoying it as much as I'm enjoying playing it for you. I shall see you all soon. Have a wonderful evening, and good night for now, folks.